Hi Leute und willkommen zurück. Wir sind jetzt auf Lennigis gelandet und schauen wir mal, was uns hier auf dem Planeten erwartet. Kann ja eigentlich nur schlimmer werden. Also schön ist anders.
What in the world?
This being Renan territory, I was prepared for a lot of things to look different. But this? This is a bit more than I anticipated.
The very foundations of the city have shifted. What could have caused this?
When Lennigis changed shape, it must have had an effect on the interior, too.
Maybe when they sent the wedge down to Dana?
But they wouldn't move around the places where people live. These are their homes, right?
I would think the citizens themselves didn't have much say in the matter. Either way, locating the Forbidden Zone just became that much trickier.
Dohalim? Is that you?
Avakir, I'm glad to see you're well.
So it is you! But why are you here? Shouldn't you be down on Dana participating in the crown contest? And these people!
So you haven't heard what happened on Dana then?
Heard what?
Someone you know?
An old friend.
Hey, Dohalim, don't tell me you've started keeping company with-
They're with me. More importantly, what's happened here?
I'm really not sure. The city's foundations began to shift without warning, and now everything looks like this. We're all waiting for the Sovereign to tell us what's happening, but so far...
Avakir, listen to me. We're looking for the Forbidden Zone. Do you have any idea where we might find it?
The Forbidden Zone? What business could you possibly have there?
Trust me. The less you know, the better.
You're just the same as ever. I wish I could help, but what with the changed topography, I can barely locate my own home. Let alone the Forbidden Zone.
Very well. It looks like we'll have to find the way there ourselves.
Have you seen Faria yet?
No.
I see. Well, nothing much has changed with her. If anything, she's probably even more...
I can well imagine.
Why did you come back? You know it can only result in pain for you both.
I've no doubt of that.
You really are the same as ever. Fine, I understand. Just don't say I didn't warn you. And take care of yourself, okay, Do?
Okay.
So who's Faria?
Law?
If what Avakir said is true, it would seem the people of Lennigis are being kept in the dark about what's happening down on Dana.
They seem to be just as clueless about what's going on up here in their own world. Despite the fact that it's actually here that the wedge originally came from.
We need more information. Let's talk to the citizens, see what we can find out.
While we're at it, we can ask them about the Red Woman, too.
And don't forget about finding the way to the Forbidden Zone, either.
Let's leave the talking to Shion. We can't have a bunch of Danans poking their noses around.
Good idea. I think that's for the best.
I shall assist.
You sure?
Being a lord on Lennigis has its advantages.
Right. Then we'll leave it to you two.
Okay.
The Danans among us should probably keep our heads down.
What could be so important? It's worth destroying people's livelihoods and homes in the process. It's just unbelievable. Uprooting an entire city as if it were mere building blocks. Someone's got an awful lot of questions to answer.
From how it looks, they must be siphoning off astral energy from Dana and then sending it to Rena.
But why do all this? What for? Surely they can't be using all that energy for the crown contest.
Whatever their purpose, disrupting their siphoning process alone won't be sufficient. Not while we still don't know what their endgame is.
He's right. We need to stop this from happening ever again.
This Forbidden Zone might be where we find some answers, right? So what are we waiting for? Let's get moving!
You heard him. We don't have time to stop and chat. Let's move.
Hauptsache, die machen ihre Stories weiter, wo sie noch erzählen. Sie wollen jetzt ganz schnell vorankommen.
So, I've been wondering, do you think when Lenegas was built, it was even made with people living here in mind?
What do you mean?
Well, none of this happened by coincidence, right? They must have designed it to transform like this. But then, if they knew people were going to live here, you'd think they would have taken that into consideration, to avoid all this chaos.
Ordinarily, yes. You'd think so. Trust me, as far as we were concerned, Lenegas was our home, nothing more. No one knew about all this. It makes you wonder whether the city was just built on as an afterthought. But if so, to what exactly?
Sorry. That probably sounded weird, huh?
Not at all. Sometimes it takes an outsider's eye to help you notice what you've been missing all along. This place is a mystery, that's for sure. Something tells me we'll find answers where we're going, though.
Yeah, you're right, Shion. I'm sure we will.
Ist Lenegas erledigt? Das Wohnviertel zerbricht in tausend Teile. Gut. Oh, die kann heilen. Angesichts der chaotischen Zustände im Wohnviertel gab es unzählige verletzte Sachen, fallen herunter oder die Leute stürzen. Oh, alter Mann.
Oh, dear me. What an unspeakable mess this has all become. Just look at the state of our city. Even the Zugels have stopped heeding our commands. Whatever did we do to deserve this?
You really have no clue what might have caused this?
Would that I have. Alas, there was no warning, no prior decree. His Highness must have deemed it unnecessary for us to know. We have no choice but to grin and bear it. But do my eyes deceive me? Could I really be standing in the presence of His Lordship, Dohalim of the House Ilkaris? I believed he was on Dana.
Your eyes do not deceive you. It is I, one and the same. I have returned to fulfill a special duty, the details of which I cannot divulge.
As your Lordship wishes. First, Lenegas mutates beyond recognition. Now, this unexpected visit? The Sovereign's plans are inscrutable indeed. The Ilkaris House has produced a great many lords over the centuries. I shall be praying for your victory in the latest crown contest.
Your good wishes do me an honor.
Also die Zeugen greifen auch alle an. Und sind nicht mehr kontrollierbar von denen. Wo bin ich? Ich war nur spazieren, aber jetzt weiß ich nicht, wo ich bin. Weiß nicht, alles fällt auseinander. Sieht völlig anders aus. Ich erreiche auch Mutter und Vater nicht. Müsst euch keine Sorgen machen, Kinder. Ich bin sicher, es gibt eine Erklärung für alles, was vor sich geht. Was selbst die Zugel laufen frei herum. Das scheint mir etwas gefährlich. Zugel sind mir nicht mehr als unsere Diener. Sie mögen ausgebrochen sein, aber ich versichere euch, ich habe sie bald wieder unter Kontrolle. Wenn ihr Kinder euch als stolze René erachtet, dann seid tapfer. Wir haben die Situation im Griff, ehe ihr euch verseht. Okay. Okay. Das Winken ist ja auch blöd. Warum gehst du nicht hin und hilfst ihm mit der Hand runter? Das ist ein Blödsinn. Oh, kann ich heilen. In all meinen Jahren habe ich noch nie der erdmächtige Heilungsartes gesehen. Tiefsten Dank für eure Mühe, einer alten Frau wie mir zu helfen. Rezept für Obstparfüm. Nice.
Everything will be okay now.
I know the basics of healing arts, but my skills pale in comparison.
Your lordship! Oh, what a great honor it is to finally meet you. I descended to Dana during the last crown contest also. Alas, when the contender I was backing failed to clinch the title, I returned. I witnessed the deaths of so many slaves.
Indeed.
Sorry to interrupt, but we're looking for a woman dressed all in red. Have you seen anyone of that description?
All red, eh? No, I can't say I remember anyone like that. I imagine she'd stand out somewhat, too.
Yeah. What about down on Dana during the crown contest? You didn't see anyone like that hanging around the lord you were serving?
What's with all these questions? I've never seen her, okay? Not recently or otherwise. Why do you want to find her anyway?
Never mind. Forget I asked. Sorry to take up your time.
Ist vielleicht keine gute Idee, jeden hier zu fragen. Das ist ja nur verdächtig. Die Sugel haben plötzlich nicht mehr auf unsere Befehle gehört. Sobald wir uns umdrehten, sind sie gegen Horizont davon gestimmt. So etwas ist noch nie vorgekommen. Wir müssen den Kampf um die Krone unterbrechen. Wir können unter diesen Umständen nicht vorführen. Was? Okay. Vielleicht haben sie es durch den Kai kontrolliert, die Sugel? Nur so eine Vermutung?
Is everything okay? You look a little lost.
Hmm? Oh, yes. I can't seem to find my way home, is all. I was just about to make my umpteenth attempt at a new route.
I was hoping to head this way myself. The situation is a real pain, huh?
I suppose the Sovereign knows best. I daren't stay here too long, though. A lower caste can only linger around these parts for so long before I outstay my welcome. I was hoping to avoid it, but maybe I'll have to go that way after all.
You mean you know another way round?
Lord Dohalim Ilkaris! But how? Last I heard, you were in Dana competing in the crown contest.
Yes, strange, isn't it? If you know another route, we'd be grateful if you could tell us.
But of course. Please forgive me. There's a wall that sprung up ahead of here, with what looks to be an entrance in it. I thought maybe it was a passageway between the different quarters, but I've no way of knowing for sure.
It's worth investigating, at least. I shall go and assess the situation. In the meantime, wait for me here. If it looks safe, I'll come and let you know.
You'd really do that for me? A lord troubling himself for someone of my lowly status?
Our lot in life is of little consequence. We are both Renan, first and foremost.
Why, yes, my lord. Thank you.
Well, we've canvassed the city for information. What do you think?
No one has the faintest idea what's happened to the city after all. They haven't heard the news about the crown contest either.
You'd think that info would easily find its way up here. Has it always been like that?
Not to this extent. Which would indicate that something's suppressing the truth. That Lenegus is under some kind of control.
Given everything that's happened to their city, the people here seem weirdly okay with it all.
Yeah, that one guy even said Zugul had stopped listening to him. If that's true, these people are in big trouble.
Everything that happens here is attributed to the Sovereign's will. It's the way people have been conditioned. Their belief runs deep. Nothing happens devoid of a reason. To them, it's all part of the Sovereign's grand plan.
The Sovereign's plan. There is one thing I'm still not sure about. Just who is this person ruling over Lenegus?
The Sovereign, of course. He rules from Renna while presiding over both Renna and Lenegus.
Without the lords or anyone in the middle doing his dirty work? Isn't Renna at least the same size as Dana? That's a pretty big dominion for one person to rule over. I would have thought ruling Lenegus alone would be difficult enough.
And the points you make are valid. Though I confess I'd never given it much thought before. Here, the Sovereign's total authority is as natural as night turning to day. Come to think of it, I know nothing of the nature of how Renna itself is. Shion, have you ever been... No, forgive me. Have you met or crossed paths with, or even heard of someone who's actually made a visit to the homeland?
No, I haven't.
Neither have I. In which case, I would imagine that... But no, surely not. Can it really be that no citizen of Lenegas has ever been there?
Hold up, what are you getting at, Dohalim?
Assuming what I believe to be correct, it's possible that no one on Lenegas has ever laid eyes on the actual Renan homeworld itself. No one but the Sovereign, that is.
But what about trade and communication? There's got to be a flow back and forth, sure.
Not if the Sovereign is imposing his will on Lenegas single-handedly. It could be a one-way street.
But I thought you said that the Sovereign's all the way over on Rena. If that's the case, can he really rule directly over Lenegas from so far away? What if something were to happen to the city, like now?
I'm beginning to wonder what the nature of this Sovereign even is. Alphen said he was forced into the role, right? Just before the ceremony. But Sovereign is also the title given to the almighty Renan ruler. So which one is it?
Whoever wins the crown contest inherits the throne from his or her predecessor before becoming ruler over all of Rena and Lenegas. Thereafter, that individual is known as the Sovereign. Though, it would appear that the current ruler has gone silent. As for how Volron factors into all this, at this point, I no longer know what to believe.
3 centuries ago, I became the Sovereign here on Lenegas. No, not just became, I was forced to. Me, a Danann. 300 years later, we cross paths with Volron, who also bears the Sovereign's crest. That's not the only thing we have in common. We both became Sovereign without winning the crown contest.
Do you think Volron was made Sovereign for the same reason? Because of that ceremony?
I can't say for sure, but it certainly sounds like it.
But that would mean that 2 sovereigns would need to exist at any one time. One whose job it is to rule, and the other for ceremonial purposes. We never did see Volron's body back in Ganeth Heros. Is a new ceremony underway with Volron at its center this time? Could that be what's causing all this strange activity here?
Wait a second. You don't think Volron and the Red Woman are working together, do you? The ceremony can't go forward without the Renis Alma. The same one that the Red Woman stole.
There's something else the ceremony needs. A maiden. And unless there's another one out there aside from me...
Questions, questions, and yet more questions. Ones that it seems will remain unanswered until we can establish the Sovereign's identity.
If the Forbidden Zone really is off-limits to everyone but the Sovereign, that seems as good a place as any to start. For the sake of liberating Danna, too.
Then it's decided. That's where we need to go.
One of the citizens mentioned a passage that she thought might lead to another section of the city. Let's go find it!
Lenegas Bürgerschaft, yeah.
I didn't realize Renan suppressed their own kind, too.
And yet, weirdly, none of them seem to mind. Am I the only one who finds that strange?
It is the way things have always been, so no one thinks to question it. You have experience in that regard yourself, do you not?
Unquestioning acceptance of your own servitude. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Even so, the quality of life here seems much higher than any Danann city we visited. I used to think it was impossible to build an ideal society without wealth. But I suppose having it doesn't always mean people are treated fairly either.
More to the point, not a single citizen seems to have even heard of the Red Woman.
What if she's not here? What if it turns out we're looking in the wrong place entirely?
It's still too early to say anything for sure.
For all we know, she might be able to blend in, move around unnoticed. I say we hold off judgment until we've exhausted every avenue.
With nobody left to run the show, I wonder what the people here are supposed to do. I mean, they're sovereigns up on the Renan homeworld, and all their lords were sent to Danna.
But Dohalim was a lord, right?
Only current acting lords have power. Renan society is quite strict about such matters.
Even if the other lords were still around, I doubt they'd be able to do much about the situation.
I wonder what they'd think if they were here to see Lenegas now. Balsif, Cannabelt, Almadria, and Volron. Now that I think of it, aside from Dohalim, we know next to nothing about the other lords.
Well, yeah, why would we? To us Danans, they were just enemies we needed to overthrow. Nothing more.
I know. But seeing Renans in their own city,
going about their day-to-day lives, it gets you thinking.
It feels strange to imagine the Lords living here too, you mean?
Yeah, a little.
If you're that curious about them, why not try inquiring with some of the locals? Every Lord in their household has their share of supporters here on Lenegas. And luckily for us, the people here are unaware of the events on Dana, which means they should be more inclined to talk to us.
Und noch mehr Story.
Tell me, Dohalim, has that skill of yours got a name?
And what skill would this be, pray tell?
You know, when you're talking to people around town, the way they suddenly become putty in your hands.
I'm afraid I don't quite follow.
I do. It's called friendly intimidation. Look imposing and speak in a deep, booming voice, and presto, you'll have people wrapped around your finger in no time.
I would never stoop to such scandalous tricks. Any feelings of intimidation are solely in the eye of the beholder.
So there is a knack to it! How do you learn it? Can anyone do it?
Now you've got me curious. Is there special training to master?
Let's see. An obsession with being elegant is a must. Oh, and it helps to be old-fashioned, too. Bonus points if you speak in a way no one can understand.
If you've a bone to pick with me, it'd be quicker to just come out and say it.
What? They look up to you, that's all. I'm just helping them along.
Hey! What's got into Alvin and Law all of a sudden? I can barely understand a word they're saying. And what's with the weird poses? Was it something they ate?
I hope you're willing to take the blame for this one.
I wasn't expecting them to take me so seriously. I'll go and have a word with them.
Reden wir mal mit den ganzen Lord-Supportern. Ihr wollt wissen, welchen Lord ich unterstütze, wieso? Werbt ihr um Unterstützung für jemanden? Ich stehe auf Seiten seiner Exzellenz, er will sie. Und was? Ihr kennt ihn vermutlich besser als Lord Basif. Ich weiß, dass ihn viele für einen Haudegen halten. Glaub mir, ich weiß, dass er ein aggressiver Mann sein kann. Diesen Leuten ist jedoch nicht klar, wie sehr er sich um die Mitglieder seines Hauses kümmert. Es ist durchaus so, dass Haus Teldilis wenig Ansehen genießt. Die von uns, die ihm dienen, geben das bereitwillig zu. Also seine Exzellenz verteidigen wir uns gegen jeden, der uns schaden will, das ist gewiss. Was bringt mir das am Ende? Wenn ich das jetzt alles weiß?
Really?
It's possible. A change in position can do much to alter one's perspective.
So even he might have had something he wanted to protect.
Dohalim, ihr seid zurückgekehrt. Wie ich sehe, brachtet ihr Gehilfen mit. Erinnert ihr euch an meine Wenigkeit, mein Lord, gewiss doch, ja? Ich unterstütze nicht nur das Haus Ilkaras, sondern auch seine Lordschaft persönlich. So sehr, dass ich meine Wertschätzung seiner Lordschaft mit jedem zu teilen ersuche, der mir Gehör schenkt. Wie es sich ergibt, plane ich meine ausführlichen Schriften zu diesem Thema durch eben dieses Terminal zu publizieren, auf das sie jeder lese. Doch seit die Kabel nach der jüngsten Aufruhr durchtrennt wurden, konnte ich sie noch nicht hochladen. Ich weiß, da ihr mich gerade persönlich beehrt, lese ich sie euch einfach vor. Oh Gott, nein. Es gibt einen famosen Mann, dessen Attraktivität nur von der Schönheit seiner Worte übertroffen wird. Jede Silbe ein Gedicht. Okay, das müssen wir uns jetzt nicht angeben.
I guess she intended to spread it throughout all of Lenegas then.
Good thing the lines were down so she couldn't.
It almost sounded like she was praising them too.
Maybe there was more to the guy than at first glance.
I shall refrain from commenting.
Unerhört, dass jemand versuchen würde, mich von Haus Valkyris abzubringen. Was wollt ihr? Sagt mir nicht, dass ihr für Lord Dohalim arbeitet oder diese schreckliche Anedria, oder? Na, jagt mir nicht so einen Schrecken ein, um eure Frage zu beantworten. Meine Familie unterstützt seit Generationen Haus Valkyris. In der Tat, ich tue, was ich kann, um Lord Ganabelt hinter den Kulissen zu unterstützen, damit er siegreich hervorgeht. Viele halten ihn für einen grausamen Menschen, aber ich bin überzeugt, dass sie sich irren. Ich leugne nicht, dass er streng sein kann, aber er stellt Rainers Interessen von innen vorn an wie kein anderer. Ja, er wirbt sogar dafür, dass wir Dana kolonialisieren und unseren Horizont erweitern sollten, statt in Lenegas zu bleiben. So werden wir Herren beider Welten und sind auf Danas Oberfläche keine Minderheit mehr. Deshalb möchte er der nächste Herrscher werden. Sag mir, könnte es höhere, edlere Motive geben als das? Ich meine nicht. Okay. Ganabelt war ein ziemlicher Untermensch.
He was invested in helping Rena succeed. Doesn't that seem just a little inconsistent?
I'm perhaps biased in this matter, I admit. However, in my mind, while all lords vie to become the next sovereign, they're also meant to serve as guardians of all of Rena.
It seems like Ganabelt also had people he cared about until the very end.
So why couldn't he extend that?
Schauen wir doch mal in den Gang ran.
To us Danans.
This area doesn't look as badly damaged as that other district we went through.
Indeed. The effects of Lenegus's transformation appear to be less pronounced here. Or, viewed another way, this area was simply luckier.
Ja, sieht eher so aus, als wäre es glücklicher gewesen.
Pardon me.
Dieses Gebiet unterliegt der alleinigen Jurisdiktion von Haus Kaenerys. Ich muss euch auffordern, sofort zu gehen. Wisst, wollt ihr nicht vorgeben, nichts ahnend über unser berühmtes Haus zu sein, beherrscht vom geschätzten Lord Almaedria. Als doch rufe ich euch an, gut zuzuhören. Nun, ihr solltet so oder so gut zuhören. Ist euch hier aufgefallen, dass in der Geschichte von Lenegis nur wenige Frauen den Titel des Lords erlangten, um im Kampf um die Krone anzutreten? Es gibt zahlreiche Theorien zu den Ursachen, aber Lord Almaedria räumte alle Zweifel der Neinsager durch schiere Macht aus. Sie stürzte nicht nur ihren Vater und vorherige Familienanführern, sondern entfernte auch ihren älteren Bruder, um den Thron selbst zu besteigen. Sie ist eine Frau, die von nichts halt macht, um zu erlangen, was sie möchte. Eine Frau, die ihren Feinden keine Gelegenheit zum Angriff bietet. Lord Almaedria ist wahrlich eine talentierte Frau. Niemand sonst verkörpert die Tugend unserer Meritokratie besser als sie. Bald schon wird das Zeitalter einer glorreichen Herrscherin über ganz Lenegis anbrechen. Okay. Das trifft aber auch zu. Your
willingness to stoop to any low came from a survival of the fittest worldview.
And some people here not only shared her belief, but championed it as morally right too.
That doesn't make it true. Too bad they couldn't see through her.
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
Was geradezu abscheulich. Ach, ich habe gerade nur etwas über Volran gelesen, kann ich nicht helfen. Ich war immer ein überzeugter Unterstützer von Lord Urvagil Hildris, wäre er nicht so plötzlich auf der Oberfläche gestorben, wohl noch immer. In meinen Augen ist Lord Urvagil der wahre Wasserlord. Ich glaube keine Sekunde daran, dass er bei einem Unfall starb, wie es hieß. Und was Volrans Herrschaft über Garna Pharos angeht, ich mag gar nicht daran denken. Er versklavt nicht nur Denea, sondern auch Rhaenyra. Wir mögen in einer Gesellschaft leben, in der der Sieger alles bekommt, aber seine Handlungen verstoßen gegen Grundgebote unseres Volkes. Und außerdem, was für eine Erblinie soll dieses Haus Igniseri überhaupt sein? Bis er auftauchte, hatte ich noch nie davon gehört. Das kann nur bedeuten, dass er zum niedersten Pöbel der Gesellschaft zählt. Dass eine derart gemeine Familie plötzlich einen Astralpraktiker hervorbringt, der zum Lord aufsteigt, ist völlig unerhört. Nichts davon ergibt Sinn, ganz zu schweigen vom Aufruhr, der hier zuletzt herrschte. Was wird nur aus unserem Volk?
It seems like the people on Lenegis don't really know much about Volran either.
I remember being quite surprised when the Lord of Ganeth Harrows changed so abruptly.
Didn't you have any doubts that something suspicious was going on?
On the contrary. Remember, we Renans are raised to accept everything at face value.
When you think about it, the families of Renan lords must see them differently than the rest of us.
Yeah, despite the brutality they're known for.
They must have had a lot on their shoulders, carrying all the weight and responsibilities of Renan society.
Renans live in a world where strength and power determine their position in the social hierarchy, so they tend to grow up fiercely competitive. But their loyalty to their people is also strong. It's what brings them together against outside forces, and nothing exemplifies that more than the Lords.
That's what makes them the guardians of all of Renan.
Right. It's the same reason Balsif hated my guts. And Ganabelt went after you, because we're threats to Rena.
Guess that makes you an even bigger oddball than we thought.
So, Alfin, have you gained anything from all of this?
Yeah. I think it's made me realize that the Lords were all people, too. Balsif and the others, they all had their own circumstances to deal with as they went through life.
Yeah, but still, just because they had loved ones in their lives doesn't mean...
I know. What they did was horrible. I'm not trying to dispute that. But at the same time, they weren't incomprehensible monsters either. They were individuals, just like the rest of us. So I guess what I'm trying to say is...
You're saying that they weren't bad because they were Renans, or because they were terrible monsters. Even if they did terrible things, they were still just people.
Renwell.
Am I wrong?
Not at all.
Being a Danan doesn't make you a good person. And being a Renan doesn't make you a bad one. I think that's something we've all seen.
Xion and Dohalim definitely make a good case for it.
And I'm going to keep doing my best to make sure I earn that trust. As a fellow human being above all else.
So, ein bisschen Galt und ein paar Fertigkeitspunkte, nice. So, aber wir sehen uns in der nächsten Folge. Macht's gut, bis dann. Ciao.